Bradley, this is so fun. I can't believe we are 7 years old and we're skipping school to go to McDonald's.
You said it, Milo. School blows. The only place I feel happy is right here at McDonald's with you guys.
McDonald's is like a heaven that you don't have to die to be in. That's for sure.
Whoa. Yeah.
Hey, check this out.
Hey, what gives?
See this?
What's that, like the guts?
No, you dope. It's a spring. You can sell them for a penny each down at Chan's hardware store. They need them for the first Iraq war or something.
You know, you get 100 of those, you can buy a 99-cent hamburger easy.
If you're a businessman like me, you always have to be on the lookout for an opportunity.
Oh, holy smokes! I bet our food is ready. I better go get it.
Don't do it, Lucy. We're gonna get in trouble.
I don't need your charity, little girl.
It's not charity. It's friendship. What's the point of having McDonald's if you can't share it with friends?
Hey, you're right.
Hey, buddy, you can't be in here.
I'm just trying to relax.
Oh, relax? Well, it looks like you're trying to abuse this little girl. Come on.
Hey, no! I came over to him! Leave him alone!
Come on.
He's just trying to sit in the corner and maybe go to the bathroom!
Little miss, you're gonna want to shut your mouth. You know what's good for you.
Hey, leave him alone!
What? It's all right. You done more for me than you can ever know.
Here! Take this. You can sell it if you ever need money.
To the alley with you.
I'll remember you. I'll remember you.
Who's hungry?
Nice.
Hell yes.
Hey, check out the sauce I whipped up special.
Whoa, Milo. You always make the best McDonald's.
Shall we?
Flip the middle and the top. Hold the pickles for the sauce. Slap the lettuce with a hit. I'm loving it.
Cheers.
Cheers. Oh. Who put this in there?
The best.
Yeah.
It's like heaven.
But you don't have to die to go to McDonald's.
Oh shit, guys, that's my alarm. My lunch break's over. I gotta go.
Let me go.
Yeah, I better run too.
I gotta go. It's so good.
That was amazing. All right, we'll see you guys back at the apartment.
All right, see you guys.
Have a good night.
See you, bud.
Bye.
As you can see, this one's a real beauty. In fact, it's the top of the toilet market.
And how much crap does it hold?
What?
Yes, my husband takes big craps. They require an ample bowl.
Oh my God, Gina, you totally destroyed that bowl.
Don't worry about it. The toilet girl will take care of it. Oh my God.
Oh wow.
I left her a Jackson Pollock painting.
Oh my God, did you get any inside the bowl?
I tried, not really.
Hey, Milo. I know this isn't really your job, but the restroom's an all-out war zone. Diarrhea-wise. It's bloody, too. Sorry.
I think I'm gonna have to unload one before I decide to buy.
Unload one?
Yeah, you understand.
No, sir, they're...
Yeah, you might just want to go get a mop or something.
They're not really plugged into anything.
No,
you know what? Just do it. It's fine. Just do it. Just do it.
Mr. Cotty, is it possible for me to have Tuesday off? I have to go home for my Uncle Ryan's funeral.
I don't know, Lucy. Tuesdays are our busiest day, crap-wise. I'm really gonna need you here. Pay toilets don't clean themselves after all. Excuse me.
In Europe they do.
Guys, I don't know if I could take another day of working at the toilet store. This guy came in and just unloaded one of the display models. Spend all afternoon cleaning it up.
You think that's bad? My boss down at the pay toilet wouldn't even let me take the day off for my uncle's funeral.
Yeah, and I got pink eye again at my job.
Guys, let's face it. Our lives suck. We have dumb, horrible toilet jobs. I mean, whatever happened to our dreams?
What were those again, exactly?
I don't know. Be happy?
I'll tell you one thing that does make me happy. This sizzling quarter pounder meal. Yummy. Yummy, gave my tummy. Yum.
That's a good point. I mean, I can't be too mad as long as I'm coming home to some hot Mickey D's and you guys, right?
Yeah. I don't know what I would do if I didn't have these two smiling faces to come home to every night.
Well, quit it.
No! No, you quit it! Ow! Ow! No!
Whoa. This is at dinner.
Yeah,
let's not touch that.
Save it. No?
Okay.
Yeah, don't hurt me.
Just kidding.
Ow.
Oh, I scratched you.
Oh, I'm okay. I'm okay.
Slamming these dank nugs.
I've been getting reports all day that there's extra grease on the Nintendo DS, not to mention the doo-doo nightmare in the bathroom that you've yet to clean up. That's it, Milo. You're fired.
Oh my God.
Now, where have you been, young lady?
Mr. Cotty,
Lucy, what? You're fired.
Wait, are you peeing sitting down? Hey.
No.
Ew.
Hey, yeah, I'm really sorry to bother you on your break. I had another question about ass sizes.
I got fired.
Jesus H, you guys. Nothing is going right for us. I have no savings.
I have no dollars, Bradley.
Me neither, Milo.
Guys, what are we gonna do? I feel like I've worked everywhere in town. Nobody's gonna hire me.
I don't have any licenses. I want to drive big trucks, but I don't have any licenses, Lucy.
You'll get one. One day. Milo. Come on. Bradley, I have hit rock bottom here, okay? I might have to move back in with my aunt. The Slavic one.
I'm gonna have to move back into a tent.
Guys! Listen! We are almost 30. We haven't had two dimes to rub a nickel since I don't know when. We have hated every single job we've ever had. That's why we keep getting fired. Like, Lucy, do you enjoy cleaning up all the barf and the crap from the only public restroom in town? Milo, do you enjoy cleaning up all the barf and crap that's all over Best Buy? That's the thing. We need to find something that we all love and make that our jobs.
I mean, that sounds great, Bradley. I'd love that, but the only thing all of us love doing is eating McDonald's together in our apartment, okay? Last time I checked, nobody's taking applications on that. Now I gotta go change out of my work clothes because my downstairs are itching up a storm.
Damn, Milo, what McDonald's did you get this from? This is fantastic.
Oh no, I made that myself.
But it came in a McDonald's wrapper and bag.
Yep. I make my own McDonald's.
Wait, say that again?
I make my own McDonald's.
And you wrap it up as if it came from McDonald's. As if this apartment is a McDonald's. Lucy, I solved our problem. First, taste this burger.
Oh, that's good. That's really good.
Milo, tell Lucy what you told me.
I make my own McDonald's.
He made that McDonald's. Milo makes McDonald's and he's good at it. Don't you get it? We can make McDonald's here, in this apartment. A new McDonald's.
A new McDonald's. Here, in our apartment.
I think this could work. I know my boy Giuseppe down at the bakery could get us a really good deal on buns.
I can steal potatoes.
Guys, I just realized, you know how my uncle passed away recently? He was a truck driver, and since he died behind the wheel, his family, i.e. me, inherits everything in his truck. Guys. It was a meat truck.
Holy shit.
But guys, opening our own McDonald's in our apartment, it just sounds too good to be true.
Lucy, with these raw materials, Milo's skill in the kitchen and our team chemistry, this new McDonald's could be the thing that we should be doing with our lives.
Lucy, I need you to be as excited about new McDonald's as I am, or this will never work. So just tell me what you think. Are you liking this plan?
I'm loving it.
Quarter pounder with cheese. Crispy chicken ranch BLT, fillet of fish. Lucy, can we really make all this stuff?
Oh man, I don't know. Those delicious new Mighty Wings are gonna be tough to replicate.
Oh boy.
We'll never pull it off. McDonald's is the best restaurant in the world and we're just three good-for-nothings.
Hey, no, listen, we can do this. Yeah, we can do this, okay? Being a McDonald's isn't about like some standardized menu or having everything be exactly the same in every restaurant, you know? It's about good food and good friends. And guys, we already have the good food.
And we've got the good friends.
Maybe we can do it.
Leftover patties from a barbecue. A fridge full of condiments that now have a use. A bag of potatoes from Trader Joe's. Veggies from our CSA dug up with a hoe. Collect up all the oil so we can build us a fryer. How do I warm the buns? Hey, I'll use my hair dryer. It's a quarter pounder kind of day. In a sunny side up baked McMuffin sort of way. Gonna raise these golden arches and make our new McDonald's. Good thing we took that trip to Costco yesterday. Got sodas, toilet paper, now our cupboards will raid. Solo cups aplenty from those parties on our turf. Vitamix so we can whip up awesome soft serve. Grab extra sauces from our local bodega. Old food stuck on these pans, hey, they give extra flavor. Gonna move our futon out of the way. Turn our living room into our own McCafe. It's time to celebrate our new McDonald's. And once our doors are open, we'll serve up millions of smiles. Our neighbors and friends can stay for a while. Our apartment will be ready, yeah, you will enjoy it. You can snoop through our mail while you wait for the toilet. Sit down and have a shamrock shake with our super rosy. Netflix and Apple TV keeps you nice and cozy. Don't worry, we've got on demand, yeah, you won't be sad. While you gobble your McNuggets, hey, catch up on Breaking Bad. We'll have the time of our lives in our domestic kingdom paradise of homemade French fries. Every day will be a happy meal prize in our new McDonald's. Our new McDonald's. Our new McDonald's.
New McDonald's is open for business.
Hooray!
That was a great idea.
All right, hold that for a second. Okay.
Sydney,
and then walk back to that position again. And then like, oh, no, just hold that for a second. Okay. All right, and then right there. Great, and then like look at the ceiling. Great, hold that for a second.
No one's coming, are they?
What about if we threw ourselves off a roof?
What? No. All that time to think about it while you're falling to the ground. Plus, it probably hurts a lot.
Yeah, but just for an instant, Bradley. Then you're dead. Nothing hurts when you're dead.
No, we have to die. We have to die and go to heaven for real. Not McDonald's heaven. Real heaven.
Well, I guess we could take some pills.
Pills? That would take hours. No. What we need is a quick shot to the back of the head with a pistol. Silenced. Nice and quick. That's how we end this thing.
But we don't have a gun. I mean, I guess I could go out on the street and, like, find a cop and then take his gun. But then he'd probably... Oh, my God. Guys, that's it! The street! When do you want McDonald's the most?
I don't know. When I want to hang out with my best friends.
No.
When I want to feel warm and happy from my head to my toes.
No. Listen, guys, we want McDonald's the most when we see someone eating a McDonald's.
You know, this is the best, right? This is the only way to fly. The only way to fly. Man. Amen. I've eaten some burgers. This is the top.
Oh, he's fries. Mm.
Pickles.
Oh.
Come on.
Get this. McDonald's? Around here?
Yes, sir. Yeah, there's one in this apartment right over here.
Right here.
Happy day, happy day.
Check it out. Come on.
Oh, you're gonna love it.
We got McNuggets.
We have burgers.
McFlurries.
We've got chicken burgers.
We've got chairs.
Is this guy really gonna be our first customer?
I don't like him. He smells like the shit room at the zoo.
Well, listen, guys, we're not really in a position to turn down any customers, and it's not the McDonald's way. We're going to serve him the way he deserves to be served.
Can I have a cup of water?
Sure.
Thanks, miss. This old fellow real appreciates it. This is a good McDonald's. You got a bathroom?
Oh, sure. I'll show you.
That was great, guys. Everyone had a good time. It was our first great lunch hour.
I'll say, everyone had a good time. Everyone had fun. I mean, friends circles are being formed and cliques are being formed out of people who hadn't previously known each other.
Friendship has always been what McDonald's is all about.
Don't say cliques. It reminds me of when I was in high school and I used to stuff myself into a locker.
Yourself?
Let's face it, guys. We did it. Everyone said we could do it, and we did it. I mean, look at all this money. We made all our money back and almost made some profits. Not that it's about profits.
It wouldn't be McDonald's if we did.
It's just like when we were younger. Mealtime is for McDonald's.
And McDonald's is for family.
And libraries are for books.
Okay, guys, I got a couple new ideas.
Like what?
Well, so far, everyone who's come in is adults, no families. We need a McDonald's play place.
Well, I turned our bathtub into a ball pit.
Where did you get plastic balls?
Well, right now it's just a bunch of torn up newspaper, but it could be fun to play with.
I guess.
It can. I guess as long as kids have something to jump in and splash around in.
Like water.
I like the idea. I just think that...
We'll order plastic balls when we can afford to. Moving on, I put it in a drive-thru.
Really? How?
Two hamburgers and a medium fry.
The drive-thru is actually a great idea.
Here's the best idea of all. We're gonna make a commercial.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba!
I'm loving it.
Hi, I'm Bradley.
I'm Lucy.
I'm Milo.
Do you love eating at McDonald's?
Do you want to keep eating at McDonald's like you always have?
Well, you're in luck. A new McDonald's just opened up in the bad part of town. In apartment 22B!
McDonald's is about three things: burgers, buns, and buddies.
We love McDonald's, and most importantly, we love each other.
Nothing will ever change that.
Plus, the McDonald's is in our home.
Which means the bathrooms are nice. Take it from us.
We used to work in toilet stores.
Plus, I cook the Big Macs in an oven, and it makes them hot, hot, hot!
When you eat at our McDonald's, you feel the same way you did when you ate at McDonald's when you were a kid. Like $1 million.
Everyone-
everyone should eat McDonald's and feed it to their children too.
Hey, I like that.
Like it?
I'm loving it!
How are you enjoying your meal at McDonald's? How are you enjoying your meal at McDonald's?
It's fine.
Anything I can get for you? Perhaps some extra napkins?
No, my hands are quite clean. Tell me something. Bradley, is this a legal McDonald's franchise?
It's a McDonald's. Anything I can get for you? A refill on your soft drink?
No, I'm finished. For now.
Welcome to McDonald's. Can I take your order?
Just my usual, Lucy. One Big Mac.
Oh, I am so sorry, old Ray. I didn't even recognize you. I am having the toughest time keeping track of who's who around here.
Just a minor brain problem, I'm sure.
I'm sure. So, just one Big Mac?
Actually, Lucy, my dear, I think I'd like to show you something. Non-sexual. Follow me.
Okay. Milo, can you keep track of the register?
I don't know numbers.
Over here, my darling, over here. Come on. No, no, over here, dearie, over here. Yes, come this way, this way.
What's back here, old Ray? It smells like garbage. Weed.
Ah, but behind every great stench lies a great treasure. Look.
McDonald's garbage disposal area only. This sign, it looks so old.
Oh, indeed it is. But what matters is not how old it is. What matters is who painted it.
Who?
Friends. Because you see, McDonald's is not just about hamburgers. It's about friends.
Brad! Lucy! Check it out! $10!
With the $75 from earlier, that makes $85!
And with the $200,000 we have under the bed, that means we have $280,000! Yeah! Guys, we did it!
No, we did it.
That's what Brad said, enchilada face!
Who's Brad?
I'm standing at 475 this street, where in a confusing turn of events, three lifelong friends have turned a dirty apartment on the wrong side of town into Detroit's busiest McDonald's. Lucy, Brad, Milo, how does it feel to own the talk of Surf City? That's what I like to call Detroit.
It feels pretty great, Carl. It feels pretty great.
Yeah, we had no idea that people would take on to us so quickly. Like, it's really exciting.
You can say that again. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but 2 weeks ago, you all had jobs involving some sort of toilet situation. Is that right?
Yeah. That's right. Now we work with our best friends, making the food we love most in the world. And I think we all feel like we've got someone special looking out for us now.
Yeah.
So I guess you could say you're not working in a toilet store,
no.
Having the time of your life, uh-huh. And that you opened a McDonald's in your apartment.
You could say exactly that.
Uh-huh. Great. Well, that's all the questions I have. Do you have any questions for me?
We weren't told that we had to prepare anything. We didn't.
Oh, well, you can think of one right now. I'll wait.
Would you like to try this burger I made?
Well, I've never turned down food before, and I'm not about to start now. Yowza! Now that's what I call a bitchin' McDonald's. I'm gonna turn things over back to you, Ross, with the story on the whale that caught on fire at the zoo.
Yowza, now that's what I call a bitchy McDonald's.
Boys, we have work to do.
Yes, Donnie.
Good. Little birds. Yes. Excellent.
Wow, our homemade McDonald's sure is going well.
It isn't. Just kidding, it is. Oh, look. Here comes Milo.
Here comes Milo.
Hey, guys, we just got a letter from McDonald's.
What do you think it is?
I don't know, Lucy.
Maybe they want to be pen pals.
Maybe it's an invitation to something.
Oh, maybe it's a portrait of us.
Oh, wow.
Open it up.
All right.
Size and dentist. Size and
cease
dentist.
Cease and desist.
Oh, cease and desist. Notice of infringement? You take it.
Infringement.
What is that?
It's a cease and desist letter, Milo.
Oh, no. What is that?
That means they want to shut us down.
Why would they want to do that to us, Brad?
Oh, wait, let me skim this letter and see. Oh, copyright infringement, trademark violations, unlicensed, illegal, immediate closing.
Closing? Whoa, like for the weekend? No. Hang out?
Permanent.
Permanent? You mean like permanent marker, right?
Oh, permanent closing.
Closing? What, like, of the gender gap? What is going on, Lucy?
Permanent closing of your fake McDonald's.
Fake? They called us fake?
Lucy, this is a real McDonald's, Lucy!
I know, Milo! It's not me!
Baby, what are we gonna do? I don't know, but I'll go talk to them.
When?
I'll go in the morning. You guys open the McDonald's like normal. And I'll go down there and I'll try to talk them out of this.
All right. God damn it, I'm gonna...
Yes, I want to invest much more money in bathroom out of order signs. Okay. No, I love you too. All right, bye. Real tricky phone, you guys. Real tricky phone.
Mr. Thompson, I just want to let you know, we weren't trying to offend anyone. We just...
Bradley, maybe... relax.
Please.
Relax. We're just talking.
Okay.
So I'm having trouble sort of wrapping my head around exactly what it is that you guys are doing.
Yeah, well, the thing is, me and my friends, we want to make our own McDonald's.
Oh.
Yeah, no. You can't. You can't do that. So I'm going to need you to stop selling McDonald's food and cooking McDonald's food and... having a place that you call McDonald's, all of that's going to need to end.
In fact, I'm not even sure how you've convinced people that it would be a good idea to eat at your McDonald's when there are regular, non-crazy McDonald's everywhere.
Well, the thing is, people like that apartment McDonald's concept. We took the idea of an apartment McDonald's, made it our own, and people are on board.
The apartment McDonald's concept.
It's a McDonald's inside of an apartment where people are currently living. You know, like a place where people sleep, eat, do doo-doos, do pee-pees, do showers, do poo-poos, and even poop.
Look, all of this is going to need to stop, but you're a smart guy, Bradley.
Thank you.
You're the kind of guy I want on my team instead of not on my team. Do you know what I'm saying?
Do you mean that you'd like to hire all of us to work for you at McDonald's? Because we would do it in a heartbeat.
No, I don't want all of you to. I want you to.
You're the brains of this operation. All right? That girl you have, that comically stupid, cartoonish buffoon idiot that you have cooking,
they don't have what you have.
That's mean to say.
Well,
they're good hearts.
Is it not true?
It is 100% true,
yeah,
but I don't say truths out loud that hurt people, you know?
You just did.
Fuck you. I can't take that offer. My friends have to be part of the equation.
Suit yourself. I mean, have it your way right away, Burger King. But just know that I now am going to have to sue you for all of the money that you earned at your fake McDonald's, which I also would probably do even if you did come to work for me, so... Come see, come saw.
Please don't sue us.
Please?
What?
Please don't sue us. We don't want to be sued. We don't like it.
We have to.
Please don't.
No, we have to litigate.
Please don't sue me.
I can do it if I wanna. So I'm going to.
All right, fine.
So suit yourself. And if you change your mind, this is my business card.
This is your card?
Yes. Call the telephone number that's printed on it.
Do you want a break for lunch?
Sure.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm closing it.
I wonder if we're the only McDonald's that closes during lunch break.
I'm sure we are.
I bet Darth Vader wouldn't be so grumpy if he didn't have all that scuba gear on.
Hey, guys.
Hey! We're eating McDonald's!
Hey, how'd it go?
You were gone a long time.
I took the long way home through the park. Then I sat in the church for a while. Then I had a few drinks.
At a bar?
How many is a few?
Maybe six.
That's like a whole bunch.
How'd it go at McDonald's? Did you meet McDonald?
Oh, yeah.
That would be so cool.
Yeah. Oh, man.
It went... Fine, it went fine.
And?
Dan's nothing, you know? I went in there, I took care of business. So, we have nothing to worry about.
Great.
Wait, they're not gonna shut us down? They're not gonna mess with us? We're just getting away scot-free? It's fine?
Join the league, and I will complete your training.
No, no, we're good to go.
Yes!
That's awesome!
Ba-da-ba-ba!
Ba-da-ba! I'm loving it!
You guys?
Mm-hmm?
I don't think we should close during lunch anymore.
When would we eat lunch? Think about it.
Well, we do it one at a time in shifts. That way, one of us can always man the counter.
But we always eat lunch together.
We always eat lunch together.
Yeah, but our profits would increase by 20 or 30%.
Profits? Like, what are you talking about?
Those are just words, and I don't know what they mean.
Yeah.
I think we should try it tomorrow.
Okay.
I'm going to get a bath.
Here.
Get to keep our McDonald's!
Oh, it's the best!
It's like, Detroit is pretty much the city of dreams, you know?
Yeah.
And it's like, if you can do it here, you can do it in Detroit.
Yeah, if you can make it here, you can make it anywhere. That's what they said.
Hey, look, McDonald's!
What the hell?
Well, it looks like they're doing our idea.
What the hell?
Weird.
Milo.
Who the hell are you?
I'm the VP of McDonald's HR.
I'm the head cook.
Lucy, those are our jobs at our McDonald's.
Why the hell are you copying our McDonald's?
Let's just say we got some advice from a little birdie.
Let's just say that little birdie is Bradley.
Bradley would never do that to us. He's our best friend, and he wears a red shirt, and I wear a blue shirt.
Let's just say Bradley did do that to you.
Let's just say he did.
Excuse me.
Never gonna have an arm again. You're never gonna have an arm.
Is that bad?
You're only gonna have one arm for for the rest of your life.
Your arm's gone.
It's done. It's never coming back.
It's pretty funny, though.
You mean I'm only going to have one arm for the rest of my life?
I mean, you're never going to have two arms again from now on, just your left arm.
I want to have more arms than just my left arm.
No, that's never going to happen ever again. Oh.
Bradley?
Yeah?
We need to talk.
What's up?
McDonald's is stealing our idea.
What idea?
They opened up a McDonald's that looks like an apartment.
And you said everything was cool.
Everything is cool.
Not if they run us out of business.
Can they do that?
No, they can't. I won't let that happen.
Did you tell them to do this?
What? No, of course not.
Oh, really? Because two McDonald's people just told us that you did.
That's a total lie. They're trying to turn you against me.
Well, it's working!
Listen, I started this business, okay? I'll take care of it.
What?
Yeah, what?
Which part?
The part about you starting this business.
Listen, I'm not trying to start a fight or anything, but the whole thing was my idea.
Okay!
Okay, it was. That is so silly.
Oh, really? Then whose idea was it? Yours, stupid?
It was all of ours.
Then why did McDonald's offer only me a job?
When did that happen?
When I met with them.
Why didn't you tell us that?
It's not important.
Did you lie to us?
No. I told you everything was fine, and it is.
What else didn't you tell us?
Look, I don't need this kind of bullshit, all right? I started this fucking McDonald's, and I can do whatever I want with it. I could fire both of you and turn it into a goddamn Burger King. I'll fucking burn it down if I want to.
What are you talking about?
Burn the apartment down?
We're best friends, Bradley!
Like with matches?
You can't fire us, we fire you!
You can't fire me, I quit!
You can't quit, we fire you!
Stop!
Hey, I know when I'm not wanted, and I know when I am wanted. And you know when wants me? The real McDonald's. So that's where I'm going. Suck a dick!
Bradley.
What? What?
You were like a brother to me.
See you in hell, dum-dum.
You didn't even close the door.
The restaurant is failing.
You're moving too fast. The key to a good McDonald's is creating a space where people can enjoy the beef, but enjoy each other.
Yeah, I get it.
Burgers, buns, and buddies.
You know what? I have heard that saying enough. Do you know what would actually help me? Is if you picked up a spatula and helped me do some McDonald's.
No, that's your job. You have to learn.
Ugh. You know what? We are getting killed out there. All of our customers have vanished. They're all going to the old McDonald's, new apartment location. My only customer customers are 99 cent ATM users in Detroit sketch comedy groups.
Running a McDonald's is hard work and I can't help you.
No. You mean you won't help me.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, I do. You're scared. So you come over and you spout your little pearls of wisdom because that's safe. You screwed up your own life and you're afraid you'll screw this up, but the truth is you are too afraid to help me do McDonald's.
That's not true.
Yes, it is. You're too chicken.
What does that mean?
This is just annoying to the British market, so
that would be the ideal, honestly, if we are able to get to that market and we're able to do it succinctly.
How long does it take to make a burger?
Just another half hour.
You said the half hour. Okay, you know what? Forget it.
No, thank you. What?
Guys, come on!
Bradley, come, sit down.
Okay, yeah, it's nice to eat with friends.
There's no friends here. McDonald's is about two things, burgers and buns.
Yeah.
Bradley, I need you to kill your friends. You have to do it.
Like somebody's planning on committing suicide.
Old Ray, how'd you find me here?
Let's just say I had a McHunch.
Okay.
Well, Bradley, how about instead of putting your hand on that knife, put your hand on something else?
Oh, sick.
No, I didn't mean my penis. I see how it's confusing.
I just thought... Because you're opening your legs up at me.
Right, and yeah.
Like, it seemed like you were presenting your dick.
Yeah. Here, follow me. Have you ever heard of Mr. Kroc, Bradley?
Ray Kroc? The original franchise owner and founding father of McDonald's? Yeah, of course I've heard of him. I'm not a fucking idiot.
Right. Well, when Mr. Kroc founded McDonald's, it was nothing more than a tiny little hamburger stand in San Bernardino, California. Kroc was eager to start in the restaurant business, and his friends and family, they supported him, and they were so eager to show up on opening day to buy those hamburgers. Croc worked days and nights starting this restaurant. People offered to help, but he always turned them down. He shook his head and said, I don't need your help. I can do this on my own. He was stubborn as an ass. Ray Kroc would never serve a hamburger to a Jew. McDonald's was a huge success, and that success went to his head. He started canceling plans with his girlfriend, never visiting his mother, and forgetting to make doctor's appointments. Eventually, Kroc started to forget about his friends. And Bradley, when you forget about your friends forget about you. He was so busy trying to get ahead that he forgot all the friends who helped him get there, to ahead. One day, the fateful day, he made the mistake that would be the biggest mistake of his life. Kroc got a new shipment of frozen lettuce that Tuesday, and he didn't want anyone to pick it up. He didn't trust him, so he insisted upon doing it on his own. That frozen lettuce weighed more than his pride, and he tripped, fell down those stairs, cracked his head open on the floor of his very own restaurant. Blood everywhere. Like a lot of blood. No, like a lot of blood. But he had put himself as his own emergency contact, so the paperwork got very complicated. They kept calling his number, he was not there, and well, he died. He died that day dead. Well, the moral of this story is that Ray should have turned to his friends for help, but instead of asking for help from friends, he was crushed to death by frozen lettuce from Mexico. Do you want to know how I know all of this information, Bradley?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Well, I'm Ray Kroc.
Bullshit! You're Ray Kroc?
Yes. That day, when I cracked my skull open, I faked my own death to avoid the shame. I moved to Detroit and got a new name, Old Ray. It was tricky. No one could follow me because now I'm old. See, it's different. But the biggest regret of my life, Bradley, is that I didn't hold on to my old friends when I had them. Remember, son, burgers, buns, and buddies. Go get 'em, Bradley! And remember, no burgers for Jews!
Wait! Flip the middle and the top. Save the pickle from the sauce. Slap the lettuce with a hit.
Lucy, Milo, old McDonald's almost killed you guys. Worse, they almost killed our friendship. It's time to take McDonald's back.
But how?
Leave that up to Ray.
You get me inside McDonald's HQ, Lucy. I'll get you the true key to McDonald's.
The what?
The true key to McDonald's.
Is it like a door key or a metaphor?
Hey, you'll know it in your heart when you see it.
Why don't you just like tell us so we know what it is?
Follow your heart.
Yeah, follow your heart.
Okay.
Let's get to work. Burgers.
Buns.
Buddies.
Milo.
Ah!
Oh,
You'll have it your way.
Hey, that's Burger King.
Here's the beef.
Each of the three divisions carries one part of the code to the inner sanctum: dining, personnel, and corporate. Milo, you'll enter through the dining hall.
Burger off.
Burger.
Lucy, you're the people person, so your job is to go to personnel and kill everyone.
Yes, let's double McDonald's wages. Our employees deserve it. Let's throw in health insurance, too.
And that leaves me to take out the guard in the inner sanctum.
I think it's safe to say...
You're fine.
Fine. I just need to return one thing.
Well, hold on now, Bradley. I thought we were friends. Now, come on.
No, you're not. You're no one's friend. That's the point of all of this. Face it. You're old, McDonald's. E.I., fuck you. Lucy, Milo, I stopped Donnie. Knife to the head.
Nice. Yeah. Bradley, where's old Ray?
Old Ray!
Old Ray!
Old Ray! Old Ray!
Old Ray, what happened?
Did you see my fight?
No.
I won, but I'm mortally wounded.
Now, quickly, we have to make our way to the locked room to find the special key.
Okay, let's go.
Take me.
Let's go.
Okay.
No.
I'm very tired.
Yeah, sure. You have to give us something.
Come on. Oh, Ray.
Just a little Ray.
Come on.
Ray.
Stay with us, Ray.
Okay.
Go.
It's not working.
Wait. I learned from you.
It's working!
Self-destruct if you hold down the button for 2 minutes, plus all the McDonald's in the world will explode too.
There's no key to McDonald's in here.
Oh, but there most certainly is. Look around the room. It's you. You're the key
to McDonald's.
Us?
Which is why we've got to destroy McDonald's. My McDonald's.
Old Ray, that's crazy. I mean, there's no way you can...
Autodestrucción en dos minutos.
Dos minutos? I think that's actually Spanish she's speaking.
Ray, what are you doing? Make him stop!
You back up. It's up to you to spread the word of McDonald's. It's not about the billions that you serve. It's about the billions that you love. Now go!
Okay.
Old Ray, I wish I was your son.
Right, because our father would have to be a considerably older man.
Lucy, we have to get out of here.
Ray, you can't do this. You can't.
Lucy, you have no idea how I so treasured our platonic spoonings and shared cigarettes in your bed. I want you to have this.
En cinco,
burgers,
cuatro, tres,
buns,
dos, uno,
bodies.
Oops.
You think any of these people were murdered?
Old Ray's around here somewhere.
Bradley, I thought you said Old Ray was blown up by his bomb so bad that he couldn't have a grave.
Graveyard is symbolic, Milo.
Be right around here.
I thought you knew where it was.
I do. It's just hard to navigate without any roads or, you know, signs.
Well, if you don't know where it is, I think we should ask someone.
No, I can find it.
Okay, well, I'm gonna go back to the office and ask them.
No. I got it. I found it.
Yeah? Where?
It's right around
to say, because it's really fucking annoying. Pretend like we do.
There it is.
Nice one.
Luis Salazar?
He went by Old Ray, but he was born Luis Salazar.
Mm. So his last name was Salazar.
Yeah, his last name was Salazar, okay?
Okay.
Is that Puerto Rican?
Hi, Luis.
Call him Old Ray. He hated the name Luis.
Hi, Old Ray. It's Lucy. And Bradley and Milo are here, too.
Hey, Old Ray.
We just wanted to come by and say hi, and thank you for all your help.
New McDonald's is going great, man, all thanks to you.
What you did. I'm so sorry that I said your life was a waste. It wasn't a waste.
Thanks for blowing up, Ray. And you're a tree now, so...
He's in front of the tree.
Yeah.
All right, let's do this.
Yeah. Do it.
Flip the middle for the top. Hold the pickles for the sauce. Slap the lettuce with a hit. I'm loving it.
That's for you, Old Ray. That's for you.
Old Ray was born in 1984?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So was I.
There's one thing left to do.
Yep.
You want to do the honors, Lucy?
No, I can't. Come on, you're the brains behind this whole thing.
Yeah, but you're our heart.
Yeah, but you're our leader.
You're our soul. It's you, Milo.
Huh? Cool.
I can't believe we murdered those people.
Oh god, that was so awesome.
It's the story of a group of friends. A man, a woman, and another man said they were going to try and start their own McDonald's. Said it couldn't be done. Said there weren't any heroes anymore. I don't believe that, do you? Let's go! McDonald's Berlin! McDonald's Warsaw!
Oh yeah!
McDonald's in China, McDonald's USSR,
oh yeah.
McDonald's in Thailand, McDonald's in Spain,
oh yeah.
McDonald's in the gulag, but no McDonald's in space,
oh yeah.
McDonald's like a woman drives me out of my mind,
oh yeah.
McNuggets are a Big Mac, I can't never decide,
oh yeah.
McDonald's like my father takes me over his knee,
oh yeah.
McDonald's with my mother, mother, so hard to please.
Oh yeah.
McDonald's and a McDonald's and a smaller McDonald's well.
Oh yeah.
If you don't eat McDonald's, then you've nothing to tell.
Oh yeah.
Mac pray for the sinners, Mac pray for salvation.
Oh yeah.
Mac pray for the hopeless of the USA nation.
Oh yeah.
I'm a bad McBoy. You're a dirty McGirl.
Oh yeah.
Let's make McLove. In a mad McWorld,
oh yeah.
Yes, I'm your McBoy, so be a good McGirl,
oh yeah.
Let's make McLove, McSave McWorld,
oh yeah. 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 Well, oh yeah. Said, oh yeah. Oh yeah. Well, oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, with a big hole.